This video will show you how to make a simple car on Roblox. Cars can be used to transport players across maps or even for racing. Use our clickable sections to navigate this video. Click on the Model tab and make sure that Join Surfaces is unchecked. Then check the Move button in the Snap to Grid section and set its value to 1 stud. Click on the Home tab and insert a part for our chassis. Use the scale tool to resize this part and name it chassis in the properties window. Insert 4 more parts using the part button. Select all 4 of them and set the size to 1x1x1 in the properties window. Name the parts part A. And make sure that Can Collide is unchecked for these parts in the properties window. This is important because otherwise the wheels would collide with the joiner parts, limiting the ability to turn the car. Now check the Join Surfaces button in the Model tab and drag each part onto the edge of the chassis for each wheel. Make sure the white border appears to show that the part will stick to the chassis. If this doesn't appear, you need to set Join Surfaces. Right click and select Insert Object and choose a vehicle seat. Drag the vehicle seat on top of the chassis. Check for the white border to ensure it has been joined to the chassis. Then rotate it to be facing the front of the car. Now let's set up the steering ability for the front of the car. Select 2 parts named Part A at the front of the car and duplicate them by right clicking and selecting Duplicate. For each part, use the Move tool to drag it a few studs away. Repeat this for the other side. As I said, don't worry about doing the back of the car, just the front too. Select both of these new parts and call them Part B by setting the name property in the properties window. So on the inside we have Part A and on the outside we have Part B. Now click on the Model tab and select the arrow underneath the Create button in the Constraints section and select Hinge. Click the top middle of the Part B and then click the top middle of the Part A. Repeat this for the other side. Don't forget to select the outside part first. Now select both hinge constraints from the Explorer and in the Properties section set the name of them to Steering Constraint. Then scroll down and set the actuator type to servo. Set the angular responsiveness to 45, the angular speed to 10, and the servo max torque to 10,000. Click on the arrow underneath the part button and select a cylinder. Then insert 3 more cylinders. These are going to be our wheels. Select them all and in the properties window, set their size to 1x4x4. Then drag each wheel to be in line with the other parts so that the square part is aligned with the middle of the wheel. Now you may need to change the snap to grid setting in order to get the wheel in the middle of the other parts. I set mine to 0.5. Firstly, I moved the wheels to the correct area of the car, and then I set the snap to grid to 0.5 to align them correctly. I am also selecting all of the other parts of the car and moving them up in order to place them in the middle of the wheel. Make sure to leave a couple of studs gap in between all of the parts so that we can set up their constraints. Now click on the arrow underneath the Create Constraint button in the Model tab and select Hinge again. Let's do the front wheels first since they're slightly different to the back ones since we've got this extra part B. Click the middle of the wheel and then click on the middle of the outside part's face which is closest to the wheel. Repeat this for the other wheel at the front on the other side. Take your time if you need to because we need to get this right. For the back wheels, select a hinge from the constraints panel and click in the middle of the wheel and then click in the middle of the part A. Again, repeat for the other side. select the hinge constraints for each wheel in the Explorer panel and make sure to not select the steering constraints. Name these constraints wheel constraints, and then scroll down and set the actuator type to motor. Set the motor max torque to 10,000. A quick tip, if you're struggling to position the camera to create these constraints, you can hold down shift on your keyboard. This will slow the camera down so that you can get into those tight spaces. And a quick reminder, make sure that your part A and part B parts, their can collide property needs to be unchecked. Also, make sure that your steering constraints start on the outside and move inwards. You can check this by setting the constraint details property in the top menu, and this will show all of your hinge constraints that we've created. You can tell by the brown circle on the outside, which is correct. Finally, select each set of parts and wheels and group them together for each wheel. You should have four models, two of which contain two parts and one wheel for the front, and two which contain just one part and one wheel for the back. Name the models back left, back right, front left, and front right. Then select these models as well as the car and chassis and group them together. You can press Ctrl plus G or Command plus G on a Mac to group items together. Insert a script into the car by clicking the plus icon and selecting Script. For the sake of time, we're going to speed up the coding parts. Pause at any time to follow along. Firstly, we create variables for our seat and four sets of wheels so that we can easily reference them later on. Then we're going to set two variables to hold our steering angle and the max speed of the car. Then we're setting up two events. One event will fire when the steering of the car changes from the input of the vehicle seat. When this changes, we'll set the target angle of our steering constraints, which will turn the wheels left and right. Our second event is for the throttle. When that changes by the W or S keys being pressed, that will change the angular velocity of the wheels, moving them forwards and backwards. For the right wheels, we multiply the speed by a negative to make sure that the car doesn't spin out. If you're copying the code from the video, don't worry about the arrows or the dots on my screen. This is just used to indicate a space or a tab. They aren't characters which I've typed into the script. Finally, click play to test your car. If your car doesn't work, make sure that the front of the vehicle seat is facing in the same direction as the car. You might need to rotate it by 180 degrees. And also, make sure that you copied all of the properties for our hinge constraints correctly. You made sure to check the Join Surfaces tab when assembling certain parts of the car, and also make sure that you set the can collide of the parts A and B to unchecked.